Hi, Sam here from Licklibrary.com and welcome to this reaction video. Licklibrary have asked me to check out some more of the archive footage on their membership. I'm checking out this course today, a segment of it anyway, from Richard Smith. This is the Effortless Guitar Smooth Jazz Techniques, and this is Licks in C minor. And Richard Smith is a very highly respected guitar tutor and a fantastic guitar player. And yeah, let's just dive in and see what he's got to share with us.
Okay, let's start learning some of these smooth jazz licks. Again, we're going to key of C minor, and we're going to use the thumb picking technique. And I think this is going to be—it's a pretty funky track. So we're going to be using the one that we press the strings into the neck, really pretty aggressive. Now, if you really get into it to playing, you're going to start getting some kind of a callus right here. Sometimes when I have gigs that I play a lot of thumb on, I'll have actually blisters and things like that. It's just like the left hand—you start working, you do it enough, and you start developing one right here. We must suffer for our art, remember.
So already he's in with some great descriptions of certain techniques and giving the historical references. And he talks about pushing the thumb in. Well, it was a really nice kind of kinetic kind of pointer to the feeling of the technique. And I think descriptions work really well of like hold the pick like this and do this. But the actual felt sense of a technique is actually hard to articulate, but or often the most useful pointer for people. So that's great. Already 30 seconds in and it's already very useful.
Remember. Okay, this first lick, smooth jazz is so much about feel and about locking in with what's going on. So I'm going to show you the runs, but I'm going to have you make sure that you listen to the beat as it goes by, and all of a sudden you're going to hear everything make sense because the solo needs to lock with what's going on with the rhythm. And it's so much about a feel thing. And this is where the R&B influence really comes into smooth jazz. It's all about the time, about the feel. So what I listen to, usually when I listen to the track, is the hi-hat, and that really helps lock my time in. And what I've got here are a couple of runs that really work with time well. In other words, we're going to be playing downbeats, but we're also going to be playing offbeats, and it's all about the time and all about how the guitar feels. So all the articulations are important. So pay close attention to the way that I articulate things. So for instance, this first note, there's only two notes. That's the beginning of the lick. It comes in on one, two, three, and one. Okay? And I do a pretty drastic slide up. This is in the tradition of Wes Montgomery and Kenny Burrell and so forth. But the idea of playing just these two notes is to put some what we call stink on it. And that's really kicking in. And pretty much every time I play, it's a very physical thing for me. And I sing along with it, but it's more to really get my whole body into the pocket and put my whole energy into those two notes. And that again, that's an R&B method right there.
I think that's a great pointer, the audacious aspect to guitar playing and also getting the body involved. Often it can be a very cerebral kind of exercise guitar, and guitarists are famous for having back problems and all that sort of stuff because of staring at the fretboard. But actually, you know, when you watch like people like Eric Gales or Josh Smith and you know, Eddie Vai or Prince and Eddie Van Halen and all the videos of these guys when they're playing, they are moving their bodies. They're connected to the music, not just kind of cerebrally in the brain, which is where everything happens, but the movement of the body to kind of get that connection is really important. So having him sort of really articulate that, I think, is helpful for a lot of people. So this is already, you know, there's lots of gold here. We've not even began to break down the lick, so yeah, really cool.
There. That's really an R&B priority, is to have that feel going on. Okay, so that's the first lick. Let's practice that. Again, that's at the 13th fret in octave C up to the 15th fret G. One, two, three. Two, three. I'm just looping it. Okay, and when that feels really great, let's move on. The next phrase here is four, one.
Something I've just noticed as well, like the way he's breaking this down into such small segments. You know, you could be watching this and you don't have to learn the entire lick. I mean, you can do, but you can take just parts of this And there's already tons of stuff you could do, the rhythmic aspects, the octave aspect, the melodic aspect. You know, you could change the notes if you want to, but like, he's really kind of breaking down the process of how he kind of composed these phrases. So that's really cool to hear and see.
Okay, let's repeat those two. And that's the first half of our phrase. Everything we do today is going to be talking about phraseology. Antecedent, consequent, as we call it at the conservatory, call and response is what the blues players call it. It's common in everything. Bach wrote with call and response. Charlie Parker played with call and response. B.B. King is all about call and response. So here's the call. Now comes the response. One, two, three. Two, three, four. All right, did you hear it sort of call, make a musical call and a musical response? Just about everything we do today is going to have that going on in it. Okay? That's our first lick. So let's break that down a little bit more. We already played the first half. This. Two, three, four. Three, four, one, two.
I think this is, in some ways, though, there's different styles of tutor. I love the way, like, personally, I think his teaching style is just brilliant, really awesome. The fact that it's very easy to sit there, especially as a tutor myself, and you talk about every fret number, every position, but he's kind of getting straight in there, like, look, here's the first tiny bit. You can see his hands, you can hear it being played. And it allows the person to experiment. I mean, he mentioned earlier, like, you know, check out the first part of this lick, practice that, and then move on to the next bit. So it's like being in the room with him, which is a really nice thing. And it's kind of how we learn licks when we're sitting jamming with people. I think that's one of the most... I was speaking to a few of the other guys at Licklibrary the other day and making time to sit down with other guitarists if you can. And just not even asking about licks or showing each other, but just like picking up things from, oh, it looks like it's that kind of thing. Then you pick it up and maybe it's not the thing they play, but you find something new. So, yeah, this style of teaching is awesome. I just want to see how he breaks down this lick there, because there's a crunchy bit I really want to understand, which is awesome. Right. Okay, so now we're going to check out that lick with the backing track, that first one we've just been listening to. I just wanted to skip forward and just hear that. He breaks down each lick individually with the backing track throughout the course, then you play them back to back. So that's pretty cool. Let's hear how it sounds in the style of the backing track he's using. I love the way that it's just really well played. And also you can actually see him sort of reshifting his bum on the seat as he between the licks, and it's just, there's no kind of sat there just waiting for the next thing to happen. He's embodied in his playing. So yeah, just really cool. It's been a pleasure to sort of check out this lesson. There's quite a lot in this course. I mean, this one segment of the course is 20 minutes long of these kind of jazz phrases, and there's tons of them, and there's lots of little articulations. And we've already seen how, even in a few minutes, there's just tons of gold, and it's something you could watch over and over again and just pick up other tips as you go. And for myself included, just listening back to these tips like the call and response, the embodiment, the description of kinetic kind of feel of certain techniques, and the way of teaching and breaking things down, it's just really, really, really wholesome. So there we are. That's Richard Smith's Effortless Guitar smooth jazz techniques at licklibrary.com. It's available in the membership. You should check it out. We'll see you soon at licklibrary.com.